Thanks for coming out as always on a Saturday. So it's good to finally get our first scrimmage under our belt as of this being practice number 9. So we got 6 more practices left. So a lot, just like anything in a first scrimmage, a lot of really good stuff that we're excited about where we're growing to, but a lot to clean up at all positions, operational, especially with refs out there. I mean, we had 7 penalties, which is always something in a scrimmage that, especially the first one you got, trying to play clean and pretty even on both sides of the ball. So we got to make sure we improve those things. But it was cool to see some guys make plays. It was cool to see the O and D go back and forth, trying to put them in a lot of different situations, from field zones to 2-minute end of half, 2-minute end of game, and see how guys respond. And a lot of it too is me back there handling the sacks so we can keep these drives moving and make sure iron will sharpen iron on both sides of the ball. So I'm proud of how our guys compete today. Did a great job prepping for this scrimmage, especially with a decent amount of guys out for spring, some other guys stepping up and getting really good reps. So it's cool to see some guys step up. We had a couple touchdowns today. Troy Wilkie ran the ball in for a touchdown. Prince had a TD, Bolt had a TD, Trell had a TD. I think those are the 4, right, Pat? So it's cool to see some guys make some plays. There's some guys making some plays on defense too. Jeremiah Irby had a big time pass breakup, and there's a bunch of other things that are gonna show up on the defensive film that guys are doing really good. So proud of where we're growing to. There's a lot of stuff that's really good on film, especially as the first scrimmage, but just like anything, a lot to clean up.
Sounds like a pretty clean day from the quarterbacks with no interceptions thrown. I mean, overall, what'd you think of the quarterback's performance today?
Obviously, taking care of the ball was a big part of it, right? So no interceptions. Coach Cutter did a great job rolling a bunch of guys, making sure a lot of guys got reps. Malachi did a good job today. Made some good decisions, made some good throws. CJ did some good stuff today too. Made some good decisions, some good throws. Obviously, there's going to be some stuff on film for both of them that they need to clean up. And Colt came in and did a really good job too, leading the drive there at the end. So proud of where they're growing to, just like anything, seeing them where they're at practice 1 as a whole group, seeing where they are now at practice 9, a lot of growth and development. Coach Cutter, our offensive staff's done a really good job. And now it's just like anything, what kind of jump we're going to take from scrimmage 1 to scrimmage 2. So we got practice Tuesday, Thursday, another big scrimmage next weekend. What's the progress at all positions? That's going to be my thing to our team and our coaches is, okay, we are what we put on film right now. That's what I told our whole team. Like, it's not what you did last year or what you want to do this coming season or what you want to tweet about. Like, you are what you put on film right now. And how you are right now is exactly who you are. Now, there's going to be areas of growth at every position at all levels. Where do we grow from here? And then we're going to put it on film again next Saturday and then the Saturday after that. So proud of where we're going.
Was there one throw that really kind of caught your eye, you know, from the day?
There was a couple throws. Malachi had a touchdown throw to Latrell in the back of the end zone. That was a sweet play. I think it was the first touchdown of the game, if I'm not mistaken. And there was a couple deep touchdowns to win the 2-minute drills at the end of the game that were big-time throws. So there was a couple big-time throws throughout practice that I was proud to see from my vantage point. Obviously excited to watch the film and look at it more.
Didn't sound like you guys ran the ball. I know Ashton didn't play, but didn't sound like any crazy rushing stats. Was that more good job at the defense, or you wanted to run the ball better? Or what?
It's always a little bit of both sides. I'm sure there was some things on the offense that we got to clean up from a mental errors, potentially their fundamentals and technique. Defense did a good job with a lot of those things. And we do have a couple of our starting offensive linemen out too, which comes into effect. So it's good to, there's a lot of guys get a lot of reps on the offensive line because they're banged up. Coach Keene's done a really good job rotating those guys until we get some of our guys back come summertime. So I think it's a little bit of both sides, BJ. The defense did some really good things and the offense can continue to find ways to run the football because that's obviously who we are. We're gonna establish our run game.
What have you said? Can you tell us about the 40-yard pass to Prince Strong from CJ?
It was big time. I mean, especially trying to put our guys in situations. So that one, 2-minute end of game, game's on the line, to feel that stress in practice. We talk about it all the time. The best competition you want to see is your teammate every single day. That's the iron sharpens iron that you need to be the elite competitors. So seeing that clutch situation, big time throw, big time catch by Prince. That's what he's got in him. Now it's just him doing that consistently throughout all practice, continue to put on film. He stepped up in a major way. Excited where Prince is going.
What have you seen out of Troy Wilkie, and just kind of where does he fit in with the depth you guys do have at running back?
Well, Troy Wilkie, I think the absolute world of him. I mean, first off, let's talk about what he does on special teams. Plays a bunch of different positions on special teams. Then does a lot for us at running back from some of our quick 21 packages where we have 2 true running backs in the game. We also had him play some receiver this week because we've banged up receiver. He's that type of player. And excited where he's growing. And he's a guy that just wants to help the team. Those are the guys you love and want to support because he just wants to help the team. And he's continually gotten better in the time he's been here.
Do you think we could see him at positions other than wide receiver or running back on the offense this year?
We're always evaluating our team. And I tell our guys right now, like I said, to start spring ball, this is the seeding chart. There's going to continue to be movements throughout spring and even throughout summertime to make sure our guys are in the right spot to help our team.
He was originally a DB, right?
He was, yep.
Is he a walk-on or a scholar yet?
He's a walk-on.
You mentioned Irby having the pass breakup. One of the first practices we were at, he had a pick. I mean, what's he done coming in at the corner?
Yep. Jeremiah's done a really good job this spring. Just like everything, there's a lot that he needs to continue to grow in and clean up, but really, really proud where Jeremiah's growing to. He's got the skill set to be a really good corner for us. And Coach Warren's done a really good job growing him and continuing to improve him, not only our schematics, but how we play our techniques. But he's had a really good spring so far. BJ, excited where Jeremiah's going.
What can you get out of the evaluation process with a guy like Malachi today? Like when the pressure's on a little bit more?
Yeah, absolutely.
What do you get out of it today for a guy like him?
I think just at every position, Jay, you find a lot about where someone is in scrimmage situations. Not just because it's live and we're tackling to the ground, but to your point, Jay, it's because the emotions now are much higher. Okay, what are you going to be like when this stadium's packed? Are you going to all of a sudden be somebody different, right? You find out a lot where guys are at on that spectrum in scrimmage situations. Obviously, it's not to the full tilt of a game, but we want to make it as close as we can. So especially the quarterback position, we get really good information after these scrimmages. And just like anything, this is not the end of it, but it is a really good baseline of where we're at. What you put on film is who you are, and then where we need to grow to in the future too.
We were talking to Austin Bolt this week, and you know, he was mentioning, you know, every spring up until this point, he's either been changing positions or he's been injured. You know, just having the stability, you know, how's that helped him this spring, and what are you seeing out of him?
Yeah, it's huge. For Bolt's been through a lot in his time here, and the injuries that have kind of slowed his progress at certain times, he's worked his tail off to get back healthy. He's having a really good spring, and seeing what he was able to do at the end of last season when we needed him to. Big time touchdown in the championship game, seeing how he's been able to get his body healthy and have a good spring to this point. And I keep beating that horse. He's still got a lot of things that we're excited for him to keep growing in, which we need him to for this season. But he's done a good job in spring this far. Excited where Bolt's going to.
Both him and Prince, you know, can really run the deep routes. You know, okay. When you have multiple deep threats like that, just how does that help your offense?
Well, it's huge. You need to find ways to stress defense at all levels. It can't just be a running attack with our tailbacks, obviously Ashton Jeji. How do we find ways to create stress for a defense? We got to put them in conflict. We have to have receivers where you have to show 2-on-1. We can't have receivers that if they just put a corner out there, that defensive coordinator and defensive staff feels like we're fine with just that. That can't happen because then you can put 9 guys in the box and that's going to be tough sledding. Even though I think the world of our offensive line, tight ends, Ashton Jeji, and the rest of our tailbacks, that's going to be tough. And so finding ways to create conflict on a defense, and especially a receiver that demands at least 2-on-1 is huge.
With Ty Benefield, I mean, I talked to him earlier this week, and you see him out there, and he's only a sophomore, and he's kind of telling guys what to do now, and a little more leadership out of him. I mean, how's he looking this spring? I know it's a crowded position there in the defensive backfield, but how's he fitting in?
Ty Benefield is doing a great job, BJ. Very, very proud of where he's at now, where he's growing. And you see Ty, even at the end of last season, started to play a ton of football, started games for us, and he earned every bit of that. I couldn't tell you the last time a guy came in as a true freshman, not an early enrollee, came in as a true freshman and found his way into a starting role on our back end. That's very hard with the amount we put on our safeties, and we put him a lot of different spots last season. Seeing him take over that field safety spot, how he's doing it, how he's prepping, I mean, he's in here all the time. He's the guy that at 6 o'clock when I'm in my office at 6 o'clock at night, I'm looking out in the blue and he's going through his get offs by himself. That's who he is. That's the kind of guy he is. And so you see his game progressing at a high level. Coach Stockton is doing a great job with him. He has that mental makeup. He will not settle for anything but being the best. And so I'm excited where he's growing to. And he has the command when he's in there, the command of the back end. And so it's been cool to see him step in that role. And to your point, BJ, only being going into a sophomore year.
Matt Wagner is a guy that we've seen make some plays in practice. We heard he made some plays today in the game. What have you seen out of him in terms of a receiver, and what is it going to take for him to get on the field, even if Matt Lauder is going to be as special as he looks?
Yeah, Matt Wagner's done a great job at this point. Did a really good job last season, continued to grow in the schematics of our offense and even grow in his body. He's had a really good spring to this point. Still excited where he's progressing. He's a freshman. excited where he's growing to. And we want to be in 12 personnel a lot. We want to be in 13. We're going to be in 11. We're going to be in quick 21. We're going to have a lot of different packages to get weapons on the field. But it's our players' job and our coach's job to empower our guys. You got to earn those personnel groupings. You got to earn those spots on the field so we can use those personnel. But Matt Wagner's doing a really good job this spring. And just a tangent, it's been awesome to get Matt Lauder back in spring healthy. He's having a great spring at this point and excited where he's going.
Wagner's high school film was pretty explosive. I mean, has that shown up in practice?
Absolutely has. Absolutely has. Very explosive athlete. Phenomenal teammate. You see him just and how he loves his brothers when he's out there. He works his tail off. Excited where Matt Wagner's going.
With you bring up Matt and new head coach, who's allowed us to watch a little more practice this year. And the sample size seems like it's getting to be big enough. The other day, he was like dominant in every team period he did. What have you seen out of him as he continues to get more comfortable and maybe raise his you know, level of play?
Matt Lauder's doing a phenomenal job, Jay. And not only in just the big plays that we see on practice, which he is capable of making all the big plays. Matt Lauder is going to be a matchup issue for defenses. How do you deal with him? You better find a way to put a DB on him. But if you put a DB on him, you're not going to be able to get off his block. You put a linebacker on him, good luck. So, I mean, he's going to create a lot of stress on defenses and how he attacks this game. And even seeing him step up in his leadership has been huge because he's the guy in that room. And he's not only the guy in that room, he's one of the best players on our whole team. And so seeing him step into that role has been huge. And him even seeing the things that he needs to keep growing in from last season to be the best he can be is exciting.
Is he a playmaker as a tight end? And like,
yes.
I mean, you see his ability to run a little bit after the catch. And if you can't create any extra credit after the catch, you might as well throw it to a wide receiver because they might be a little more dynamic. Yep. But he just seems like he checks that box. Yep.
Matt Lauder is 100% a playmaking tight end. Absolutely.
How has Andrew Simpson kind of embraced almost kind of being the leader in the linebacker group now?
No, Andrew's doing a good job at this point. It's been cool to see him continue. And we're putting him in a lot of different – we already put him in a lot of spots, but we're even putting him in a couple different spots throughout our fronts because he can do a lot, right? Not only playing the wheel linebacker spot in our nickel package, but even when we get in some of our dime and our rush packages, we're trying to find ways to move him all over. Not that we're going to put him in those spots in season, but he has a really good skill set to be able to attack in regards to pass rush and blitzing, one of our best blitzers. But now we're putting him in spots where he's got to do even a lot more. So he's continually building his bank in regards to the techniques he's got to know. And he's done a good job through the spring. And just like him, I mean, he made some big time plays last year. But there's a lot of stuff for him as a true linebacker that he needs to keep growing. He's excited to do that. And that's what we've been on him to be able to continue growing. He's embracing. He stepped up a major way. I mean, he's a playmaker out there. And I'm excited to see him step in that role.
Is putting him in those different positions that, because I think you said he wasn't necessarily going to play those during the season, that just kind of so he knows how to instruct the defense?
Well, especially in spring, our goal is to move guys into a lot of different spots. Not too much to where they can't execute, but Drew's in his third year here. So he knows our defense very well. He knows a lot of the answers. He knows a lot of the techniques. So we're trying to put him in spots to see if we could try and expand the menu that we use with him. Because the more techniques he knows, the more you can do with him. And because he's a guy that is one of our best blitzers and is great in regards to how he attacks quarterbacks, he's going to get a lot of attention. O-lines, tight ends, slide protection. So how can we use ways to keep him on the attack to quarterbacks, but finding ways to drop him into coverage in those situations too?
Sire Gaines looks pretty physically impressive. I mean, compared to Genty, who came in here looking physically impressive as a freshman, where is Gaines right now compared to Genty when he was a freshman?
Yeah, I'm not going to compare him to Ashton, Ron, but, I mean, I'm very, very proud of where Sire Gaines is right now. You talk about an early enrollee guy as a running back, and to see what he's done to this point, practice nine, I mean, Sire Gaines is going to be a really good player for us. And I can say that because I've seen his growth and development from when he got here even to where he is now. He's that, I mean, just being frank with you guys, it's spring break. He stays in Boise because he wants to train. It's 6 o'clock. I'm helping my brother at the fire department. And he calls me and says, how many decks do we run the summertime? Because I'm about to hit him right now. That's Sire Gaines, right? He's just built different. And so he's the guy that's going to keep growing and getting better in his time. And he won't, similar to like what I was saying about Ty Benefield, he's not going to settle for anything but elite.
With whether it be guys graduating, your injury situation, how is Jake Ripp doing?
Great question.
Advantage of the situation so far?
Jake Ripp has done a great job this spring. And honestly, stepped up even more than I wanted. I shouldn't say more than I wanted him to, but he's done some really good things and even surprised us in some certain situations. We were in our base package where he's really playing outside linebacker, and he did a great job that I'd never done it before. And he stepped in and did a great job. So we're putting him even in some different spots. But even just playing true inside linebacker, he's taken a big step from last season. As a redshirt freshman last year, played a ton on special teams, limited on defense, and seeing him step up and get a ton of reps this spring, especially with Marco being out for spring. I mean, Jake Ripp's having a really good spring at this point. Still a lot of things that we're excited for him to grow, and Coach Collins is doing a really good job with him. But I'm proud of where Jake Ripp's grown.
Kind of similar last about last one, anybody?
CJ Tiller.
Okay, yeah. Two more.
Okay, yeah. I'll ask you about Chase too back in the back of the room. This is what we've seen. He just like finishes everything. Mm-hmm. I don't know, what have you seen out of him, and how is he projecting, or what's his trajectory as he tries to work his way out of the field?
Yeah, Chase Martin is one of the most explosive guys on our team. Right, I mean, not only just straight line speed, but he's extremely explosive. He's also very ball conscious. We call it ball aware. He makes a tackle. I mean, he is violent at punching the football. Last week, I think he had 3 punch outs in practice, which is uncommon, especially because we're not taking guys to the ground in practice outside of the scrimmages. I mean, he's just ball aware. He's that linebacker, and he truly can run sideline to sideline. He has that type of speed and that type of skill set. Now the biggest thing for him is just the overall schematics, not only, especially at linebacker, not only just knowing exactly what I'm supposed to do, but I got to take care of a lot of guys around me. I got to make sure the front's good. I got to make sure the communication with the back end of me is good with us at linebacker. So those are the things that we're pushing to grow him this spring. But he has the skill set. I mean, he can run sideline to sideline. He can blitz. He can cover. And something that is innate in him is he's very ball aware.
With CJ Tiller, I mean, we talked to him earlier this week, and I think his performance in the bowl game, a lot of people kind of just aren't including him in this quarterback controversy. There's a lot of talk with Malachi and Maddox, but how's he coming along, and where does he fit in all this?
No, good question, BJ. I think just like anything, every position on our team, this is a seeding chart. And as guys continue to put it on film this season, not 2023, not the bowl game, not what they've – obviously, as a coach, you take all that into consideration when you move into a new season. But it's all about what have you put on film to this point. And CJ's done some good stuff through the spring. Excited where he's growing to. It's a seeding chart. So as the quarterbacks continue to compete with each other, which they will do every single day, one guy's going to maybe get more reps one day. One guy might get a little bit more reps the next day. And Coach Cutter, Coach Cooper do a great job grading it all. It is black and white. It's not, well, I think you're doing. No, I look at the stats every single day after practice, every single day after a scrimmage like today, and this is exactly where you're at. And it's been good to see him embrace that, compete. Not, to your point, BJ, don't worry about what happened in the bowl game. Don't worry about what happened. Now grow from it, learn from it, and be the best version of yourself going forward. Keep competing. Because for CJ, for everybody else on our team, that's all you can control. You control what you put on film right now and how you grow from right now, scrimmage 1 to scrimmage 2.